and welcome to Edit 5. Back in the 60s, they really were the pirates, braving North Sea storms and seasickness to bring pop radio to Britain for the very first time. The stars were DJs like Tony Blackburn and Dave Lee Travis, bobbing about on Radio Caroline. Well, thanks to them, pop radio very soon became legal. But now, 25 years later, the pirates are back, and this time they're ashore, broadcasting from basements, sheds and attics, and often using equipment which costs less than £1,000.
I suppose they can confiscate your records and everything, and I don't know if there is prison sentences or not, but I wouldn't be too happy if they confiscated my records at all.
Also tonight, how a mother has set up a campaign to help the families who can't afford to visit their children in hospital.
We need to provide parents with, even if it's only a pound, on a telephone card so that they can phone home and sort of, you know, say to the children who are at home, we still love you, we're here for you.
But first, after 3 years on the wrong side of the law, the region's biggest pirate radio station, Dream FM, which broadcasts from a council flat in Leeds, wants to haul down the Jolly Roger and go legit. Edit 5 has obtained unprecedented access to the world of the pirate broadcasters and the government investigators who try and track them down.
Not too many problems on the region's roads at the moment in Leeds City Centre.
96.9. Dream FM. 107.8 megahertz. The heart of dance music. FM. Lost in music. 107.8 megahertz.
It's 28 minutes past 12 o'clock on Dream FM 107.8. You're listening to Alice. Don't forget, coming up tonight, Alice's Adventures in Clubland with our very special guest this weekend, DJ Solitaire G, John Gilpin.
From a potting shed in North Leeds, DJ Alice breaks the law to broadcast.
We'd love to not be illegal, but as the situation stands, you know, I think that we're providing a service, and I think it's really important that we stay on the air, and if that means that I've got to break the law to do it, then, you know, I'm afraid that I am doing that.
Sweet precious love so divine, bring on the mystery.
Since the end of last year, November time, the Radio Investigation Service has had to raid Dream on four occasions. Dream, like other pirates, set up on any frequencies that they choose to operate on. They interfere with other legitimate radio users.
Work on here mainly, it's administrative office. How's first and foremost. We're here to like answer all the calls and inquiries from listeners to make sure they get timetables and merchandise if, you know, if they want to purchase that. Hello Howard, it's Michelle from Dream Promotions in Leeds. I'd like to send you some information regarding Dream FM and radio advertising. We broadcast from Leeds, but we're covering three major cities. That's Wakefield, Bradford, as well as Leeds, obviously, and all the suburbs. We can produce the ad for you, but we do prefer if you can do it yourself. But we do have like in-house production facilities if you require them. But you'd have to supply me with a script, etc., and there'd be an additional cost.
Okay then, I'll yeah. Bye bye.
We always make sure that everybody knows, and we don't hide the fact at all. It's pretty obvious as well that we're illegal. We'll just try and make sure that we're not treading on anybody's toes too much, and that even though we are operating illegally, we try to not do anything that will harm anybody. No references to illegal activities. We can't be seen to incite anything. We also make a point of not treading on the toes of any other radio stations in this region. We would never take advertising that anybody else could have.
I DJ in clubs as well. I don't just DJ and Drum FM. I just don't think fans of dance music are catered for at all. It's like you've got one specialist show on national radio. It's a couple of hours a week, and like, dance music's just massive. It's crossed over into the charts. People want to hear dance music, and they want to hear it all weekend, and I think they should be able to.
I'm going up to check the transmitter on the roof of a block of flats and check that the aerials are all plugged in and that the box that the transmitter's in is well secured. Where we are at the moment, the caretaker's got no idea that we're there. Some people are really sympathetic towards you, and sometimes you just have to go and just do it and hope you don't disturb anybody and nobody sees you doing it. This gets the Earl of Leeds, this one. It's the best site we've had so far, and we're a bit loath to change it, really. We do have two or three other good sites in Leeds, but there's none that really compare to this. We've had reports from all over the place, really. They can receive signal from here, so we just like sticking to it. We have a link at the studio that sends the signal to a link on top of the block of the flat, on top of the block of flats. And then from there we transmit. Very rarely transmit directly from the studio. Because if we did, we'd be tracked straight away, and not only would they take us transmitter, but they'd take everything in the studio as well.
The Radio Investigation Service has got about 100 technicians throughout the country, and to give you some idea of the problem, in 1994 we undertook nearly 600 raids against pirate stations. Pirate radio is a serious cause of interference to other radio services. They cause interference to safety of life services, businesses, and they do that because they're operating on frequencies that they're not authorised for, and they're using equipment which in some cases is very rough, and our engineers have to find that equipment and remove it for the benefit of other radio users.
Are we going on? No, he's here, he stood with me.
Hello? I'll go switch it on.
Just can't get the staff.
Yeah, all right. Okay. See you soon. Right, I'm
off. Okay.
FM. Lost in music. 107.8 megahertz.
Feeling kind of real. Okay, well, that's it. We're now broadcasting to millions upon millions of people. Once again, a very good evening. Welcome along Dream FM. It's Friday evening, 107.8. Yours truly, Mike Morrison and John Land with you through until around about 8 to 8.30 tonight. See how we feel. We lost half an hour at the beginning, so I think we should get half an hour at the end. Because we deserve it.
I find the risk's worth it. I know you can be, you're banned from playing legal stations for 5 years, I think. I don't know about, I suppose they can confiscate your records and everything. And I don't know if there is prison sentences or not, but I wouldn't be too happy if they confiscated my records at all.
A any given time there's likely to be four or five in Leeds and the same in Bradford, but due to what we've been doing in the last few weeks, I would think there's probably two or three on in Leeds. And Dream will only come on later this week. This is the vehicle that's used for tracing all the pirates. This area that's coming up now is Chapel Town. We're more or less going straight forward now. It's just slightly off the front of the car. Right, we'll turn. Oh, it's still ahead, but it's going left gradually. See what happens once we turn the corner. Right, it's gone right. So we need to go further that way. It's there. It's been on there before. We've raided that address before. There.
If we do become legal, obviously it'll become more of a business, which I do think would be a bad thing, because you know we'll have to make money, we'll supply and demand, we'll have to do certain things for advertising. But I don't know what prospects there'd be for being a community-based station where you're working more of on a cooperative level would be ideal.
Now Dream has become the first convicted pirate station to apply for a licence to broadcast legally with the help of the Sheffield-based Community Radio Association.
There's an immense amount of talent within pirate radio. I hope we see today's pirates going legitimate. That's one of our aims, is that we don't like to see people breaking the law, working on the fringes outside of the law. We'd like them to come into the fold. We would help them, and we would give them all the encouragement and help that was needed to go legitimate.
100%. Exclusive. London heard it first on KISS.
Wake up this morning with a monster. Dangerous Dave Pearce. Breakfasts on KISS 100.
Good morning, it's 7 a.m. Dangerous Dave Pearce here on KISS 100. Coming up on the Dangerous Breakfast this morning, the new Public Enemy. It's a world exclusive. But kicking us off for this morning...
This is the station Dream would like to follow to respectability. 10 years ago, London's KISS 100 was the most wanted pirate on Britain's airwaves. Today, it's a legal dance music station under former pirate king Gordon McNay.
I've been in touch with Lenny Henry about the Groucho Club.
Right.
Also about comparing at our party.
Yeah, we can have him on during the awards or after the awards, probably better. I still have a skull and crossbone that we used to have in the old pirate studio. I believe in expanding the choice of radio. I think that we should have all styles of radio station. I think what's happening in London is brilliant because we've got country, western, a country station now coming on. We've got jazz, we've got soul, we've got sort of ethnic stations, we've got sort of rock stations, classical, and I think that that's great. Everybody should be given a license. Then it wouldn't, there'd be no need for pirates, but there never will be. It never gets to that state.
I think if you look back over the years, you'll see that the range of choice and competition in broadcasting is much more vast than it ever used to be. And I think in some ways pirates have helped that range of choice come about. But the Radio Investigation Service has to deal with the interference that the pirates cause, and to that extent we have no sympathy with them whatsoever. They set up on any frequency that they like and they cause interference to legitimate radio services.
If I was arrested or anything, I'd just have to take it as it comes, but I think we've got a lot of support, I've got a lot of backing. I don't think, we're actually doing anything morally wrong, even though it may be legally. I'm just trying to come on and do my thing and keep doing it well.